Yeah, what will be happening with these bikes
now that the truck is on its last legs?
Well, there's no place to run motorcycles of this type. They're strictly designed and built to be run on a racetrack. I find it a little offensive with some of the public attitudes about racing as not being socially acceptable. The Symphony and everybody else seem to ask for government handouts where they can give millions of dollars to these societies. This place has always run on its own 2 feet. It's never got a single nickel from the government. And it carries itself. There's a lot of people here that enjoy it. And up on a mountain this high, there's no reason why it couldn't have been designated a park and just left to run the way it is. It's, we live in a country that's got one person per square mile, but they've got a pick on this square mile. And I find that a little ironic that I have to go down to Seattle to run at SIR, which is surrounded by houses, but everybody seems to live in harmony. And at Westwood, there was nothing out in this corner of BC when they put the track here. It was totally wilderness. And then people want to finally come out here, build a house next door, and say, oh, the track's noisy. But the track was here long before these people ever came out this way. You know, it's like living in Richmond and then saying, well, you got to get rid of the airport. But Westwood does carry itself. It never gets any free handout monies. And I don't even think this is a good place to build a house as far as climate and weather goes, because the winters up here, you're in a cloud, just like today. And this is the middle of the summer. So I don't see any reason why they couldn't have designated the top half of the mountain as a park and just left Westwood alone. And I don't particularly have a lot of faith that they're going to ever come up with enough funds to build another track in the greater lower mainland. So it's unfortunate, but it may all just disappear.
Just make sure it's breathable.
Not really here, huh?
Remember, the farming chains, they don't adjust too tight because these really expand, right?
Okay. That's exciting.
And,
you got your letters here?
Oh, you got them there? Okay, good.
Keep the rubber on the floor, eh?
Yeah.
Help me.
I just thought you were beyond help.
That's our wife said.
All right, quiet, please. I need your attention, and I need it well, because we're well over 1.5 times as many bikes as we've ever had before. We've got about 125 here, and unless everybody plays it very careful out there, we're going to have problems. The starter's not here today. He'll be here a little later, so I'm going to go through the starting flags. Robert's going to help me, and Wayne's going to help me, because I'll forget a lot of stuff.
Is everybody here?
The first and foremost thing I want you to do out there, especially this morning, because it's going to be wet, is to take it really careful. Westwood's not a bad track in the wet, but if you're not experienced or you push it too hard in the corners, you'll be gone. And with that many bikes out there, you can take a lot of other guys with you. So above all, especially today, pitter-patter around.
Flags. We'll go through the flags first. This is the old Canadian flag, when Canadians were Canadians.
It is a vintage Canadian flag.
It is a vintage Canadian flag. We use this as the starter flag. The starter, when he starts a race, well, actually, there's a riders' meeting before the race, so you don't need to know that. We'll do this again before the race. Okay. A black flag. A black flag.